एमकॉम बिजनेस इनोवेशंस, द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पिलर इज अकाउंटिंग फॉर मैनेजर्स. सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट इन दिस क्लास. सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर सपोज टू ज्वाइन प्लीज 10 मिनट्स बिफोर द स्टार्ट ऑफ द क्लास फ्रॉम टुमारो ऑनवर्ड्स. सो इफ द क्लास टाइम इज 8 AM देन यू मस्ट ज्वाइन दिस क्लास बाय 7:50 AM so that we can take the full utilization of 40 minutes which has been given to us through this online class. So as per the instructions received from the Punjab University yesterday, the full semester will be online. There will be no offline class. So all of you will be studying through online mode. And secondly, we will be following hybrid system of teaching. When I say hybrid system of teaching, on alternative day, we will be meeting through online. But on certain days, like Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, we will be interacting through WhatsApp. And I will be sending you, on alternative days, one or two chapters, which you have to study, grasp, and next day that chapter will be discussed in the class. Because in the hybrid system of teaching, you have to cope up with the speed as well as quality, and it is expected from the students that every student is following a quick path of studying along with the online class, as well as you will be studying the notes which will be sent to you through WhatsApp group, which I have specifically formed for your subject, and accordingly you will be interacting next day. So in this way, whatever the days, because university may take your exam in the March first week, the semester exam. Apart from that, there will be certain online exams of this semester test also. So your examination will be offline, but your teaching totally will be online. So this is because of the COVID situation, which we are all facing throughout the last 7-8 months. So therefore, you have to cope up with all these things and cooperate with all of us, because it is your benefit to gain out of this online class. And whatever maximum you can utilize, and I can assure you, because we are taking online classes of earlier, your seniors also, and this class may be more useful than the offline class. So when I all say to you that you must on your videos and audios, it means while studying in the class, you will remain interactive with your teachers, as well as you will remain interacting with your all fellow students also. I have one request to all of you. When you join online class, so kindly join through laptop. If you are joining through your telephone only or your mobile phone only, you may not get advantage of the full online teaching methodology. Because on the mobile phone, you cannot see clearly the view of your whole class. Secondly, you cannot see the whole view of the presentations which will be made by me as well as by you while interacting with the students. So it is my humble request, those who can manage, they must try to join through their laptop, and they must immediately register on the Zoom website their names and email ID, so that you may not feel any difficulty while joining this class. So as far as the subject is concerned, this subject is also a hybrid accounting system, in which we are not going to study only financial accounting. We are also going to study cost accounting. We are also going to study management accounting, because the name of the paper is Accounting for Managers. Because this MCOM Business Innovation is a totally different course than the general MCOM. The specific purpose of general MCOM is to just prepare the students for school and college teaching, nothing else, because they are not supposed to be professional. they are just giving the glimpse of the commerce, and they are not experts in any specific field. But as far as this MCom Business Innovation course is concerned, this is a basically professional course. You are lucky that you have joined this course without entrance test. Because of the COVID situation, there was no entrance test, and sole merit of your graduation class was taken into consideration for admitting you in this class. But as far as this course is concerned, this is a very, very advanced course, let me tell you. And if you are not able to cope up with this, the requirements of this course, then you will not be nothing. You will be nothing, neither MCom, neither MCom Business Innovations. So before continuing this course, you must have the agenda in your mind that for what purpose you have joined this course. So as far as the purpose of this MCom Business Innovation is, we have to prepare the professional both for the teaching of commerce and business innovation, as well as for preparing the professionals for industry. So you have a dual role. As far as the general MCom students are concerned, they can apply only for assistant professor in commerce. But you have the dual role. You can even apply for the assistant professor in commerce as well as assistant professor in business administration or business management. So you have the dual degree, that is MBA as well as MCom. So therefore, you must get advantage of it. General MCom students will be studying only 7 papers, but you will be studying 8 papers in every semester. So it means they study only 28 papers, but you will be studying 32 papers. So therefore, your course is advanced course than the general MCom. So you must consider yourself superior, not only 100%, but 500% superior than the general MCom, because that is just a basic course which has little value in the market, in the professional field. So therefore, you, all of you are lucky that you have joined the MCom Business Innovation. This is just like MCom Honors, which is running in the Punjab University campus. So now let's come to the subject which we are going to study. The subject which we are going to study is basically accounting for managers. So it is expected, because in general MCom, only commerce students can join BCom who has passed out. But in MCom Business Innovation, even the students who has passed out BSc, BA, or any other stream of graduation, they can also join MCom Business Innovation. So therefore, the basic course of accounting for manager is designed keeping in view the requirements of all kinds of students, and it is presumed that you have not studied accounting in the graduation level. So the course design for accounting for managers is prepared in such a way. But all of you are commerce students. I have seen the profile of all the students, and it has been found that all the students are basically commerce students. So therefore, you have an advantage that you have studied all the things previously in your graduation class. So it will be little advantage for you to study this subject in more easiest manner. So as far as accounting is concerned, you have already studied accounting at various levels, at plus one, plus two level also, and also at the graduation level. So basically, the financial accounting has evolved over the number of years into a specialized profession. So the type of accounting which we were studying in plus one and plus two has emerged gradually, and the number of accounting standards has been evolved over the year. And now this has become a specialized profession. So as far as accounting profession is concerned, like other profession, like medical profession, lawyer profession, this profession has also, over the number of years, has developed into a specialized profession. So as far as we know, accounting, the accounting process starts with the recording in the journal, and then we post the entries into the ledger accounts, then we prepare the trial balance, and then we prepare the final accounts, and this is the end of the process. After that, we prepare the financial statements so that it may be circulated to the various stakeholders and shareholders. So in this accounting mechanism, we follow various things. We follow a particular kind of accounting cycle. So accounting cycle starts when a transaction happens. After that, that is recorded in the day book. And after recording the day book, then it is posted in the journal. Then the ledger posting is done. Then after that, summarizing the various accounts in the form of trial balance. And after that, its analysis is done in the form of the financial statement. So we follow a particular accounting mechanics so that we can arrive at the logical conclusion and we can submit the reports to our various stakeholders and shareholders. So in this methodology, we follow proper pricing policies for the valuation of inventories, stocks we receive, which we purchase, that is entered in the journal on certain prices, then when issued, when sale is made, proper pricing methodology is followed. And after that, we adopt various fixed assets are there. We adopt a depreciation policy. So we want to know that how the profit is maximized and how the earning of the concern has happened. So this kind of accounting mechanics we follow. So basic objective of our introductory lecture will be restricted to that what is accounting cycle that is followed by the business. Secondly, we will study what kind of basic records that every business maintains. Then we will study when the revenue is considered to be recognized, then when how the inventory pricing and valuation is done, how the depreciation is calculated, what are the various methods of the charging the depreciation. Similarly, we will arrive at the conclusion that how the financial statements like trading profit and loss account and balance sheets are prepared. So this will be the basic objective of introductory lectures, which 2 or 3 days we will take. And just that we will be having a glimpse of it, ki how the system is works under the accounting system. So basic records which we prepare for accounting. So if we consider the definition of which is given by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, they have defined accounting as, accounting is basically an art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transactions and events which are part of at least of financial character and interpreting the results therefore. So if we consider the definition given by the AICPA, that is American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. So accounting is what? Basically, it is an art. That means the accounting system works in a particular fashion and which requires certain kind of skills. So in this art, we first record the transactions. Then we classify them into different segments, that is in the form of a ledger. Then we summarize, various accounts are summarized in the form of trial balance. And then we prepare the financial statements so that we can record the monetary transactions only and which are of at least financial character so that we can interpret the results of the organization, that is the outcome that may be in the form of profit or loss. So from this definition, it is very clear that this process of recording the transaction in appropriate books, classifying the various accounts, and summarizing in the form of various financial statements and communicating them to all the stakeholders and shareholders is known as accounting cycle. So if we look at the accounting cycle, concept of accounting cycle, first, the transaction is happened. Secondly, that transaction is recorded in the day book. After that, that transaction, which is recorded in the day book, that is transferred into the journal or subsidiary books, as the case may be. After that, periodically, we classify them into the, putting them into the ledger accounts, then prepare the trial balance. Then this summarizing part is over. After that, we prepare the trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet, which is known as the financial statements. So after that, we follow the path of reporting. So accounting standards, accounting cycle, starts with the concept of transaction, happening of the transaction, and ends with the circulating the financial statements to the various stakeholders. So that is the concept of accounting cycle that we have already studied at the graduation level or at plus one, plus two level. So in this, first we have the day book. That is just a book in which the transaction is just named that on this particular date, this transaction, for example, we started business with cash rupees 20,000. On 1st January, we will write in the day book, 1st January started business with cash 20,000. So this is just writing the transaction in the day book. After that, we transfer this transaction in the form of entry in the journal or subsidiary books as the case may be. So basically the first entry which is made, that is made in the journal or subsidiary book. So journal is known as the original book of entry. So it is a book in which the transaction is recorded for the first time in the form of journal entry. So whenever a transaction happens, it is immediately after writing to the day book, it is recorded in the journal. So this is first we prepare, and all of you know the rules of preparing the journal, what are the different kinds of accounts that you know. So I'm not going to repeat them in detail because it is expected from you that in hybrid system of teaching, whatever you have studied at the graduation level, you must recapitulate them. This is my basic purpose, is to just to recapitulate all the things to you. And once the journal is prepared, we transaction which are recorded in the journals, they are transferred into the ledger entries. So ledger is a book where transactions are grouped and classified into several ledger accounts. So the closing of these accounts give the inputs for the preparation of the trial balance. So ledger accounts are prepared periodically according to the need. So if you are preparing accounts on 1st January to 31st December, the ledger accounts will be closed on 31st December. If they are prepared on the basis of the financial year, then it is closed on 31st March. So this is the second step. Third, after the ledger accounts are prepared, all accounts are closed at the end of the year, then we have the balances of various ledger accounts which are opened in the ledger. Their balances are transferred to the trial balance. So after ledger accounts are prepared, a statement showing the accuracy of the recording of the transaction is prepared with the help of the closing of the ledger accounts, and this statement is known as a trial balance. So this is usually prepared before the preparation of the final accounts. So matching of the debit and credit column total implies that the recording is accurate, arithmetically accurate. But logically, if you are wrong, then there inaccuracies may be there, but trial balance, meeting of the trial balance is presumed that your accounts are arithmetically correct. So once the trial balance is prepared, the next step starts with the preparation of the financial statement. The first statement to be prepared is trading account, which shows the gross profit made by the concern for the accounting year. And after preparing the trading account, every business has to prepare the profit and loss account, which shows the net profit earned by the company during the current year. So the last statement which is prepared, which is prepared to know the financial position of the business on a given day, usually it is the last day of the financial year. So this statement shows the closing balances of various assets and liabilities of the business, which is known as the, we can say these are the balance sheet. So this is the accounting cycle which we follow in while preparing the accounts, financial accounts particularly. So as far as the preparation of financial statements are concerned, you all are familiar with this. So because every business has to prepare its own financial statements at the end of the accounting year. So financial statements are basically shows the operational results of the business for a given period and also give the financial position of the concern on a given date. So financial statement prepared by the manufacturing funds, if it is a manufacturing concern, then first you will prepare the manufacturing account. After that, you will be preparing the trading account. And after that, you will be preparing the profit and loss account and the balance sheet. So financial statement prepared by the trading firm will include only trading account, profit and loss account, and the balance sheets. So what is trading account? What is profit and loss account? What is balance sheet? I'm not going to repeat here because all of you are commerce graduates and know all about all these things. The notes which I have sent to you, which is the chapter which is known as Accounting Mechanics, Unit 2, Accounting Mechanics, which is written there. All these things which I am talking to you are explained there. So you have to, certain financial statements are given, trial balances are given. You just have to prepare the trading profit and loss account and balance sheet and recapitulate all the things which you have studied at the plus one, plus two level or at the graduation level, because this will save our time. So it is my humble request to you, the notes which I have sent to you for on page 4, one trial balance is given and certain adjustments are given. So it is expected from you that while recapitulating whatever you have studied at the graduation level, you prepare trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. Certain illustrations are given it. So you study all these, and on the basis of that, we will fare again, follow the path of progress in our education. The most important concept which are there, I would like to discuss with you. First important aspect is, when you prepare trading profit and loss account and balance sheet, you have to keep certain things in mind. Most important thing is revenue recognition and measurement. So under, we know that we have two system of accounting. One is cash system of accounting and another is accrual system of accounting. And in financial accounting, we basically follow the accrual system of accounting. So under the accrual system of accounting, revenues from the sale of merchandise are considered to be earned in the accounting year in which the ownership of goods passes from one seller to the buyer. So as a result, even though cash for the sale may not have been collected until the next period, the revenue is recognized as being earned at the time of the sale. So usually, when we prepare the financial account, revenue will be considered to be recognized when it is basically transaction actually happened. If the delivery of the good has been given, may not be cash received, but this transaction will be treated as happened and the profit or loss on this transaction will be recorded in that financial year. So sale revenue is regarded as earned if the following conditions are satisfied. First, the seller has passed the legal ownership of the goods to the buyer. Secondly, the seller price, selling price of the goods has been established. The buyer has paid the purchase price, or it is certain that he will pay the price in future. So if any of these conditions are not fulfilled, revenue will not be considered as recognized. So revenue will be considered as recognized when the seller has legally passed the ownership to the other, may not be payment received. So therefore, we should consider one this aspect while recording the transactions. Secondly, we have to, for preparing the profit and loss account, we have to match the revenue with the expenses. So during the process of preparing the trading profit and loss account, the relevant expenses and the revenue expenses are matched to arrive at the operating results of the business, that is the profit or loss. So expenses may be recognized as manufacturing expenses, office and administration expenses, selling and distribution expenses, and revenue may arise from the sale of the products and services or from the sale of fixed assets or from the income from investment. So in trading account, manufacturing expenses are matched with the sales and closing account to arrive at the gross profit, and in profit and loss account, the office administration, selling and distribution expenses and along with other non-operating expenses are matched against the operating and non-operating incomes arising out of the business. So in this way, matching of revenue and expenses are made to arrive at the profit or loss figure, which is the end result of the business transaction. Similarly, while preparing yourself for the course, you must also consider certain things. You must recapitulate the inventory pricing and valuation method, which may you may have studied in the cost accounting also, or in plus one or plus two, when pricing of material issues chapter was discussed, so first of all, we must define what is the term inventory. So basically, inventory refers to unsold goods purchased or manufactured. According to accounting standard 2, revised, any inventory is treated as assets held for sale in the ordinary course of business, in the process of production for such sale, that is work in progress. Similarly, in the form of material or supplies to be consumed in the production process of in the rendering the services. So anything which is held for sale, anything which is held for production for such sale, or any in the form of material or supplies to be consumed in the production process, that is treated as the inventory. So as far as the term inventory is concerned, it includes the finished goods also, it includes work in progress also, and it includes raw material and various components also. So as far as what is the, why we evaluate the inventory? Because we have to arrive at the income concept, and we have to arrive at the, what is the value of the inventory, so that the true financial position of the business can be ensured. So just I will be taking the name of certain inventory valuation methods. So there are various methods which we follow. For example, we follow first in, first out method. The price at which the material was first purchased will be issued first, and after that the next stock will be used. Similarly, last in, first out, the price tag which we purchased recently will be used for issuing the material. So first in, first out, last in, first out, specific identification method. Similarly, highest in, first out, the highest price which we have purchased will be issued first. So base stock method, we can have some base stock on the first, that base stock will be issued, after that the new methodology will be followed. Next in, first out. So weighted average price method. So these are the various methods which we follow in the process of inventory valuation. Similarly, in depreciation, we charge various kinds of methods. Straight line method is there, fixed installment method is there. Similarly, written down value methods are there. So there are number of methods for the depreciation we also use. It is expected from all of you that when you come for the next time with the chapter which I have sent to you, read that chapter in detail. That chapter will be giving glimpse of all the things which you have studied at the graduation level. All, basically all chapters that you have been studied by you at the graduation level. But here in hybrid system of teaching, we will be moving towards certain advanced concepts which are expected to be studied from the postgraduate student. So it is humbly requested to all of you, the chapter which I have sent to you, which incorporate, I think, certain more than 51 pages, in which 10 exercises has also been given. So it is expected from all of you that you solve these all exercises, so that after reading the concept in the chapter, you try to solve these. The concept of cost sheet is also given there, that we'll be discussing in the next class. So it is expected from you that you read this chapter, Accounting Mechanics, thoroughly. Try to solve the problems which are given at the end of the chapter, so that you can have the glimpse of various concepts which you have studied at the graduation level. So this is all for today, because this was just an introductory lecture to give you certain inputs so that you can have about your subject and prepare accordingly. So one thing I am going to give you one favor, that chapter or the lecture which I have delivered to you now will be available to you tomorrow on my YouTube channel. So whatever I have discussed with you, that you can repeat time and again, whatever I have discussed with you, you can go on my YouTube channel. Whatever is there today discussion, that will be available on the YouTube channel also. So you can again listen. If something is missing, you can recoup it. But it is expected from you that all of you must attend the class regularly, whenever it is held. Alternative days, meeting through the Zoom, or alternative days, meeting through WhatsApp chats or through other channels also, will be remain connected. But it is expected from you that as Corona has changed the lifestyle, Corona has changed every system of functioning, we have to change ourselves. If you are expecting that classes will be held soon, that is not going to happen, because there are a number of issues. A few days back, Government of Punjab opened the institution for final year classes from 16th of this month, but yesterday again the Punjab University has to take a decision because it is not possible that all the students may be COVID tested or all the teachers may be COVID-tested. Therefore, the university has taken the decision that online teaching of technology will continue. But in cooperation with along your cooperation and my cooperation and working synergetically, we can create this class much better than the offline class. If you continue or you continue to appear in your classes regularly, try to interact it, so then it will be beneficial to all. So now 5 minutes are given to you. If you have any query, you can ask. You are most welcome. Your questions and queries are welcome. Any questions? Yes, Mansi. Mansi Puri. What do you want to say about today's lecture?
The lecture was so good.
Baki jane apni awaaz mute kar lo. Only Mansi will speak. Yes, Mansi.
Yes, sir.
हाँ बोलो.
सर लेक्चर बहुत ही अच्छा था. एक्चुअली सब कुछ वही था जो हमने ग्रेजुएशन में पढ़ा हुआ है, बट काफी अच्छा हमने सब कुछ रिकॉल कर लिया. जो पॉइंट्स थे वो सब कुछ दिमाग में आके सही हो गया. इंट्रोडक्शन वाज वेरी गुड.
ओके. यस करमजीत. करमजीत कोहर 5901.
हाँ जी सर, लेक्चर बहुत अच्छा था. मेरे को कल कुछ डाउट्स थे तो मैंने नोट्स करे थे, बट अब वो सारे क्लियर हो चुके हैं.
वेरी गुड. देखो बेटे, दिस इज बोथ वे ट्रैफिक होना चाहिए. अगर मैं ही कला बोल के तुम्हारी क्लास करके चला जाऊंगा तो फिर अपन ऑनलाइन टेक्नोलॉजी का कुछ ज्यादा बेनिफिट नहीं हुए. देखो कंप्यूटर है तो 500-600 रुपए का कैमरा बेटे लगा लो, या थोड़ा लर्न करो कि तुसी अपने मोबाइल फोन नू अपने एलईडी टीवी नाल किवें कनेक्ट कर सकते हो. वो एक छोटा जा कैमरा लगा लो या मोबाइल ही टंग दो और उन्हों अपने टीवी अटैच कर दो तो तुसी एक वड्डी स्क्रीन मैं तुहानू सारयां नू देख रहा, मैं तुहानू एक वड्डी स्क्रीन दे उत्ते देख रहा और हरेक पर्सन मैनू विजिबल है कौन कौन बैठा होया क्लास दे विच. ठीक है जी. और असीं इस क्लास नू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग नालों भी वधिया बना सकते हैं क्योंकि असीं तां सिर्फ 40 स्टूडेंट ही होना है. साडियां मैक्सिमम सीट्स किन्नियां ने 40. सो 40 स्टूडेंट्स दे नाल एक पर्सनलाइज्ड टीचिंग जिहड़ी है ऑनलाइन कीती जा सकती है और मोस्ट ऑफ द एडवांस कंट्रीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड दे विच यही चल रही है. सो देयरफॉर इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम यू कि तुसी सारयां ने क्लास नू डिलीजेंट इतना कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव क्लास है. तुसी थोड़ी जी टेक्नोलॉजी नू यूज करके इसको बहुत वधिया बना सकते हो. तुहानू भी मौका दूंगा बहुत सारयां नू स्टूडेंट्स है
Sir, 5919 roll number is present.
Okay.